Good morning, everyone. It's so awesome to be with you again, even though we can't see each other face to face. I hope you guys had an amazing holiday. And those of you still on holiday, I hope you're enjoying it. And I know for some of you, school is going to start a bit later, but we're going to take it and it's going to be awesome. I really hope you're going to enjoy this time with us, and yeah, that it may just be a blessed time for you. And I just quickly want to pray for us. Father God, thank you that we can be together. And okay, I'll just share your word. Please go with us, and also through the week that's coming, that it will be an awesome week and that we'll just lift your name on high. Amen. Guys, enjoy today. Enjoy the music and enjoy the story. Bye-bye.
Day in history, death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. Empty cross and empty grave, life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
time, guys. I hope you guys really enjoyed it, because I know I did. So now we're going to get into our word time, okay? So get your Bibles ready, and we're going to read from Job. So the story that we're going to read can be found in Job 1, 2, and 42. Okay, so later on you will have some time where you can read it on your own and discuss with your family about what you have learned from there. Okay, so I'm going to read a little of a story for us. So here we go. Job lived in Uz. He was faithful to God, so he was a righteous man. Job had 7 sons and 3 daughters. He also had 7,000 sheep, 3,000 camels, and 500 oxen. So there we can see that Job was a rich man, okay? So God gave him lots of things because he was a righteous man. 500 female donkeys and a very large household. One day, Satan told God that the only reason Job was faithful was because he had much and he had an easy life. So God told Satan that he could do anything to Job except lay a hand on him. So here, Satan came to God saying that, but Job has so much, it's only because you have given him so much. That's why he loves you. God was like, okay, let's see if that is true. So he said, you can do anything to him that you want, but you cannot put a finger on Job. So let's see what happened. Soon after, a servant came to Job and told him that the oxen were plowing and the donkeys were eating beside him. Then a sunbeam came and took them and killed all their servants except him. So now all his donkeys and oxen are dead, plus some of his servants. While the servant was talking, another came and told Job that a fire came from heaven and burnt up the sheep and those servants, all except him who came to talk to Job. Then while that servant was talking, the chandeliers came and took the camels and killed all the servants except him. Again, while that servant was talking, another one came and told Job that all his children were eating a meal, and then came a great big wind and killed everyone except that servant that was talking to him. So just think about it. All of a sudden, things are just happening and everything is gone and you are left with nothing. Let us just think about how Job would have felt about that. I think he was heartbroken and he was so upset he didn't know what to do. So let's read on and see what he does. Job stood up, tore off his robe and shaved his head. He fell to the ground and said, "The Lord gives and he takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." Job did not get angry and shouted God for his misery. So there we can see, even though it was going so bad with Job, he still praised God. And he said, God gives us blessings, but he also takes some things away. And yet he still praised God. Let's see what happens next. Now Satan told God that Job was faithful because of those things. That he had servants, lots of children, animals, he was a rich man. And now all of a sudden that was taken away and it didn't hurt him physically. So God said to Satan, you could do what you want except kill Job. So God said to Satan that Satan could do anything to Job except kill him. So he could make him sick. He can make him hungry, but he cannot kill him. So let's see what happens next. The first thing that Satan did was put painful boils all over Job, from his top of his head all the way down to his feet. So it was like open sores the whole time that would not get better. Job was broken, like a broken pot, to scrape himself. So Job used the pot to make sure that he was scraping these things open, to clean, keep himself clean. Then Job's wife starts telling Job to curse God because of what is happening to him. Job told her that sometimes there's good in life and sometimes there's bad. And Job did not curse God or sin. So there we can see that Job is showing us how we should react in bad times. That even though things are not going the way that we want them to go, God has got the plan. And He this will always make it good for us. She gave him really bad advice. And then, three of Job's friends came to him. They didn't even recognize him. They ate with Job for 7 days and nights and didn't even talk. They did talk after that, and Job stayed faithful and didn't blame God. But Job did have questions for God. And God answered Job out of a whirlwind. Job said, "I know you can do anything." So even though Job was so badly hurt, so God spoke to Job in a whirlwind. And Job said to God, "I know you can do anything." When Job prayed for his friends, God gave Job back all that he had, that he had lost, and he even doubled it. So God gave him even more than what he had. So all the animals that were lost, all his children that were lost, all the crops that he lost, all the servants that he lost, God gave him even more than that, because Job stayed faithful. God blessed the last days of Job. So we can see that God blesses us. Even when we can't see it, God still blesses us. Through good times and bad times, God will still bless us. But we need to remain faithful. Okay, so there will be a few questions that I'll send to Mommy and Daddy that you guys can answer with each other and talk about it. So I hope you guys enjoyed the lesson. See you next time. Bye.
I hope you enjoyed the songs. I hope you enjoyed the story. And yes, just have an amazing week. See you again next week. Bye.